Hey everyone! In this video, we're going to use a hardware debugger to debug Flipper Zero assertion failures. I'm using an ESP32-S2 for debugging instead of the Wi-Fi dev board for Flipper Zero. If you have a dev board, then you can skip ahead to 3 minutes 39 seconds. Alright, let's get started. We'll open Windows PowerShell as an administrator. And then do CD and into any temporary folder that you have. Click on the code dropdown and copy the get path. And then we'll type get, clone, and then right click the path. Then we'll CD into that directory. Then we need to install a driver, so scroll down in the README and find the driver from here. And then we'll go ahead and download that driver, the Universal Windows driver, and say keep. And then we'll click on Show in Folder. We'll go ahead and right click on the file and say Extract All. We'll scroll down to the INF file and right click, and then choose Install. And hopefully the install is successful. Back in PowerShell, we can do the pip3 install -R requirements.txt. I'm going to update pip by copying the command it shows. And then I'll do the pip3 requirements one more time just to make sure it works. Then I'll hold the boot or zero button, and then I'll press and release the reset, and then I'll release the boot button. Now we'll run python 3 easyinstall.py. When it starts, it's going to pull down all the necessary files. We'll choose Flash Flipper Black Magic. If you haven't held down the boot button, then you'll get this error. So make sure you've held boot and then press and release reset and then release the boot button. After it's done, I sometimes get this traceback error, but it doesn't seem to impact anything. So you can see that pin 10 on the flipper goes to GPIO1 on the ESP32. Pin 11 goes to ground on the 32. Pin 12 goes to GPIO2 on the ESP32. And then if you're using Wi-Fi, then you also need to connect to 3.3 volts. I'm using USB in the first example, so I only need 3 wires to the flipper. The clock is the brown wire, the ground is the black wire, and the yellow is the IO wire. So the brown wire is going to GPIO1, and then you can see the yellow wire is going to GPIO2. And then I've connected the enable pin over to the 3.3 volts using that white wire. And then my ground wire is going to ground on the flipper. In this second example, I'm using Wi-Fi, so I have 4 wires. I have that 3.3 red wire, and then I still have the brown clock, black ground, and yellow IO wires. This time I'm connecting to an expressive dead cap. You can see it's connected to the GPIO 1, 2, 3.3, and ground on the dev kit. So let's go ahead and take a look at the assertion we want to debug. So I'm going to go into miscellaneous, basic scene demo, into my Lotto, back out, and you can see I just crashed. And there it is, Flipper crashed and was rebooted. Fruity assert failed. So over in Visual Studio, we're going to open up that launch.json, and I'm going to rename this from blackmagic to blackmagic-auto. For me, I found I have to comment out the FBT quiet for things to work. And then I'm going to add another section called blackmagic-menu, and you can copy this from my GitHub tutorials. In a terminal window, we ran fbt get underscore blackmagic, and we're copying that value and putting it into the menu. Then we'll scroll down to the blackmagic section, and we'll switch it to blackmagic-auto, or -menu. And then over in the debugging pane, when we click the green arrow for attach to blackmagic, you'll see a menu now. I'm going to hit escape. We'll switch back to auto. And this time it'll automatically detect what our environment is. So I'll switch from terminal to debug console, and then I'll type compare -sections. if any of the sections don't show matched, you may want to do a Control Shift B and choose Flash USB with resources. Everything looks good, so we'll hit continue. Then we'll bring up QFlipper and go back into our application. And then we'll try to reproduce the assertion by going into the lotto numbers and then pressing back twice. So behind the QFlipper app, you can see that we've actually hit an assertion. Over in the call stack pane, we can see that Fruy Crash was called by view dispatcher Free. It's asserting that we have zero views. In our variables window, we'll expand out view dispatcher and we'll look at those views. And we can see that there is two views still instead of zero. We could have also hovered over the views variable and then expanded it to also see that there's two views. So it looks like app free is the method that called our view dispatcher free. So we'll go ahead and type detach down in the debug console so that the debugger is no longer attached. And then at the top of the debugger, we'll also click on stop. So the assertion was happening because we were missing these two remove view calls. So we'll go ahead and implement those two calls. We'll do Control Shift B and choose launch app on Flipper. We got an error because QFlipper was running, so we'll go ahead and close QFlipper and do Control Shift B again. Launch app on Flipper. And then we'll go into lotto numbers and press back and make sure that the bug was fixed. In this video, we looked at how to use the ESP32-S2 to make a Blackmagic probe to debug our Flipper apps. We configured Visual Studio so that we can launch the debugger. We saw how to debug an assertion call, looking at the call stack and the variables. And then finally, we detached our debugger. I have a written GitHub tutorial as well. Please like and subscribe and leave any comments below.